with me in order, we all stand for the pledge of allegiance, please. A pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We understand, Dan, we stand for the anthem?
What?
We gotta stand for the anthem?
Everyone stand for the national anthem.
I'm just gonna roll call the members present, please.
I guess so.
Councilmember Witten.
I'm here.
Councilmember Conover.
Present.
Councilmember Biggs.
Here.
Councilmember Graham.
Here.
Councilmember Justin.
Here.
Councilmember Paparo.
Here.
Councilmember Reavis.
Here.
Seven present.
Thank you very much. Okay, here we are again, day two. We'll start with the airports. Okay, three. Now, second reading. How are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, how's the work out there at the airport coming?
We've had a fantastic summer involving the runway project. We closed on April 27th for roughly 70 days. Got the airport back operational before our largest traffic with Oshkosh in the Collins Foundation bombers. As soon as the bombers left, closed up again, did the grooving and final markings, and we have an active runway as of today, so right here.
Excellent, very good. Okay, well, you have the airport budget in front of you, 8101, aviation, what's your pleasure?
I'll make the motion, it gives a discussion.
Yeah, I'll second it, discussion.
Are we putting raises in, or are we holding them till the end?
Well, that, my friend, is up to you.
I thought we were holding them till the end.
So, here's what we're gonna do then. We're gonna back those raises out, if that's what the body wants to do, and deal with them at the end.
Just to recall, we do that because the council cannot increase our budget.
It's perfectly fine.
Yep.
Yep, we understand completely, I don't blame you. So,
last year's figure?
Last year's figure.
That's what I'll make my motion on, if you'd like.
Motion concurs with the, alright, second concurs, any further discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Airport team building?
I'll make the motion.
Second.
It went down, Kyle.
Yes, it actually was reduced by the DLGF because of a change in rate.
Okay.
So our new number's 242032.
That's my motion.
And second concurs, all in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Approved. We'll get back, we'll come back and look at your raise proposal when we do our raises.
Very good. Thank you.
Alright, have a good one. OE, Opportunity Enterprises, 1087. Zoe here. Well, well.
Motion to deny.
Want to start? Next.
Well, you don't want a motion on this, on OE?
Well, we can come.
If they show up.
I mean, we'll deal with it at the end, she may show up, she may wanna be here.
Well, that's not gonna have much choice anyway.
Hi, everybody.
Hi.
Hey, how's it going?
Good, this is Socorro Gonzalez, she's controller at Porter Stark, she's been there over 30 years, Mary's out of town, so Socorro came with me tonight.
Hello.
Alright, what do you have here? So you have Porter Stark's proposed budget in front of you, what is your pleasure?
Am I looking at the 242? What?
Are you looking at what?
203343.
203343.
The levy went up, or the levy went up? I'll make the motion.
Second.
Discussion.
What's the explanation for the higher proposed 17 budget?
The levy increase.
The levy went up.
They kind of have, they don't really have their own levy, right? It's just kind of a, they increase our levy to accommodate the, with the growth factor, their budget. I think OE's the same way, correct?
OE and Porter Stark, they don't have their own levy, you're correct, in the typical sense. But their, the amount that we appropriate for them gets added back to our max levy.
So if we were to, for example, cut them to zero, they would just reduce our levy?
Correct.
Yeah.
So you don't open up the general fund.
So you can't say, so if we even, we save them down, it doesn't help our...
I think zero is a little drastic, Mr. President.
Okay, a motion and a second on the floor for 2033343. Any further discussion?
Did you want to say anything about what's going on?
No, I just gave you a handout to kind of sum up some of the services that we have added in the last year, some new things. And you talk about growth, and I think it's in the last year, we grew 13% as far as number of clients served.
Good.
This number is Porter Stark, so there is some Stark numbers in there, but overall, 13% growth in the last year, and most of that is Porter County.
Okay, good.
What is that, in your opinion?
You know, it's the need for behavioral health care services just continues to increase. That's, we're not unique in that area. It's a nationwide thing. You know, we all hear about the addiction problem constantly. You know, this is opioid addiction week. It's just constant. And the biggest challenge, once again, I remember mentioning this last year, is finding additional physicians, psychiatrists. There's a nationwide shortage on that, and we're actively recruiting. Good news is we have a new one, an additional one, I should say, starting October 1st.
Have you had a big turnover in psychology?
No. Our psychiatrists, most of them are there for 15, 20 years. Once they come, we do a pretty good job of retaining them. There's just a nationwide shortage of, we're constantly recruiting for psychiatrists.
So you're saying a significant portion of this is due to an increase in opiate?
Not a significant portion of it is, but some of it is. And just, again, the need for behavioral health care services. And I think on a positive note, and I think more and more over time, people are more reluctant, less reluctant, I should say, to seek out these services now. I think there has been a lot of progress in reducing the stigma of mental health and addiction, where more people that in the past were reluctant to receive services are now coming out and receiving services. Also, a lot more efforts in outreach, a lot more work in early intervention and prevention, so we're getting a lot of younger people in, too, which is good. So, hopefully,
so they're just walking through the front door asking for help?
Call, walk through the front door. Most people, you know, more people were seen in the emergency room in the hospital, more people through corrections, just every area. It's a business that you don't really have to work hard to get the patients. I hate to say that. You know, there's just always a very high demand, and keeping up with that demand is the biggest challenge.
You know, Rocky, with the shortage of psychiatrists, is that especially a problem with adolescents?
It's probably 20 times worse for adolescents and to find a child and adolescent psychiatrist, I should say. However, the one we hired is a child and adolescent psychiatrist that's going to be joining us in October.
And what's causing this shortage?
Well, that's a good question. A lot of reasons. The medical schools and residency programs aren't able to keep up with demand to place students, and we're actually working on a program with one region and Indiana University Northwest to set up a residency program in Northwest Indiana. However, that's going to be several years in the making before that could comes to fruition. So that's one thing. Another thing is that a lot of people are reaching retirement age, so a lot more are retiring, and a lot of people chose early retirement as a result of a lot of the changes that have taken place in healthcare, especially with electronic medical records and things of that nature. So if you have a psychiatrist that's been practicing for many years, and now all of a sudden you have to use an electronic record, or I was going to retire in 2 years anyway, I'm going to retire now. That, and then you have a new generation of physicians coming in, no offense against the new generation, by the way, but they know that they're in such demand. So they want to work less hours, they don't want to take on call, things that are necessary, so they're more demanding in terms of the jobs they will take. And like I say, there's opportunity for them everywhere, you know. So
All right, well, thanks so much.
Yeah, it just kind of sums it up, but we're working at it, and we're constantly recruiting. Like I say, good news is we have one starting October, an additional one starting October 1st.
Very good. All right, all in favor of this, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.
Family News Services Bureau. This is something that we funded out of...
Interest.
Hospital interest last time.
Move to approve.
There's a motion on the floor. Is there a second?
Second.
And a second. Discussion. I mean, we still have our hospital interest fund, right?
Yes.
How much do we have in there right now?
$4.8 million. Let's see if my memory holds right.
$4.8.
$4.1 million.
You were only $700,000 off.
Sorry.
That's okay. Motion and a second on the floor. Any further discussion?
When you all originally came to the county council asking for assistance, it was at a time when the federal government had cut back their assistance. That's what was causing that void.
You're talking about when the original amount was increased to our current amount?
Yes.
Is that what you're referring to? Yes, it was.
Has there been any movement on the federal side since that time where they're going to...
Very little. There has been very little additional ability for us to receive money through grants through the state and that loads of the money from the feds. One of our programs that was significantly cut that forced us to initially put that Portage property on the market, which we've taken off, that program has only increased maybe 1.5 staff people. That's the only increase that we've seen. The other program that we have seen a significant increase allowed us to hire 1.5 staff, and that is going to be our CASA program, and that's the increase in the number of children being removed from their homes directly related mostly to substance issues. The state's been really on top of that and increased a half a person last year and one person this year. And at this point, we will now be able to serve all of the children that are on the CASA list in Porter County because we literally have to have a paid CASA. Cannot keep up with the numbers of children being removed from their homes.
So other than this, how much other money do you get? What's your total overall budget to run the operation with all your programs?
A little over $2 million. We have about 19 different funding sources. That would be separate state funding sources for grants, Victims of Crime Act, the CASA.
And those have decreased still, or are they...
Not all of them. Not all of them have decreased. Several of them decreased significantly, and the big decrease that we were talking about earlier was when the state pulled back all of the money for residential services, for local residential services. That created all kinds of closures of programs like our NEQA Center and the original Learning Place.
So that was primarily state programs, not federal?
Correct. That one was state.
So the money that you are requesting this year for your budget, that specifically, what is that geared for? What programs does that... If we didn't give you this money, what would you be looking for?
Literally, I can tell you the exact programs that it covers, but it actually, before I get to that, I can explain that it actually covers the services for the whole county because we're not able to provide...
Okay, so you don't have to do that now.
Oh, okay.
Between now and maybe our final reading, why don't you give us kind of a spreadsheet or a breakout of the programs that you have still? I'm curious. And, you know, your overall budget, cost of the programs, and that kind of thing.
You want it in a spreadsheet? Would you like me to do a narrative?
Whatever's easier.
Okay, and a copy for everyone.
Please.
Because you can see that we're funding this out of the hospital interest.
Yeah.
That no longer, there's a burn rate now ignited with that because we're no longer putting into it annually. So the question becomes now is how sustainable is this?
Well, I'm just going to tell you, I think that we've had a lot of discussions, and this isn't particularly just with reference to you, but as our foundation, and we're going to hear a report next Tuesday that's going to tell us that we've got some pretty good money coming in. We're going to have to develop some sort of program or some sort of guidelines at the foundation level, I would suspect, if not at the county council level, as to what we're going to do with the earnings from the hospital are the foundation. How much of that are we going to set aside for things like, we talked the other day about law enforcement, public safety stuff, social services, that kind of thing? And we might really want to be, as we're moving forward, on a year-to-year basis, having some of the social services agencies maybe making a presentation or a proposal or a request based upon their funding needs, their programs, and we may have to get into a situation where we prioritize those things and how much money we set aside for social services. And, but that is a chapter for the, or a comment for the next chapter. But, okay, well, we got a motion and a second on the floor. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? So if you can get that to us, like I said, well, our final reading is when we adopt the budget, so I'd like to see that in advance, if you would.
I will get that for you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Yep. Board of County Services. So we're still sort of in the same boat with this one.
So we don't have to go through this.
No.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Motion to second on the floor.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Can I see?
Yeah, I mean, these are the kind of things we can look at between now and our final reading. Because I'm sure there'll be questions, but I don't really want to get into that right now because I haven't had a chance to look at it. But, so what we'll do is,
you've got a budget on the top and you've got the activity on the back, so the number of rides and, you know, stuff there.
Yeah. So that sounds great. So what we'll do is, we have a motion and a second on the floor. I would suggest that we approve on second reading, take a look at these things, and have questions for a third read. Any problem with that? Because I want to be able to look it over. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? So Bruce, that's what we'll do. If there's questions, we'll holler at you. But
sounds good. Thanks.
Thanks. Appreciate you bringing this.
Dan, I think it'd be helpful to have the Family Youth Services Bureau do the same thing, just provide us with their overall budget.
Yeah. Isn't there a way to ask for this?
I don't know if you heard that.
Did you hear that, Lisa?
I did. That's pretty much exactly what I asked for. Their overall budget, their program, cost of programs, and yeah. But I'm with you.
Yep. That's good.
Could we dwell on something if we're here, Mr. President?
There you go. Bruce, you still here? He's gone. What were you going to ask him? Is this something worth bringing back in for?
Well, I'm just curious on their expenses. They have depreciation.
Well, why don't we ask that when he comes back? Because I'm going to look this over, and I have a lot of questions.
Well, that one just jumps right out at me. Because they're not profit.
Okay.
Thank you. How do you depreciation and not profit?
Okay. Coroner. Well, we're just having a ball.
Motion to deny.
I'll second.
He didn't show up.
Where is
he? Weights and measures.
Well, I mean, it is defense. There's no change.
Okay. Sir Budget, what if we have questions? What if there's no changes, but there's some areas where we need to cut? I'm not saying that with the coroner, but because he's usually bare bones. But
move to approve.
Weights and measures. We got 69,545. Is that your motion?
Yes.
Yeah. Nothing has changed. There's a second on the motion, a second on the floor. Discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? The ayes.
Thank you. Thanks, Mike.
These people all know about them. Yeah. We've got folks that said they couldn't be here.
No.
Cool. Veteran Services. How you doing, man?
Hi.
So, little bit of change on maintenance agreements.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Motion in a couple of seconds. Any discussion? Keep doing what you're doing.
Thank you very much.
All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Thank you.
Thank you.
Extension. How are you?
Okay.
Close. 10,000 up. Where we go up at? A little bit in contractual.
Hourly.
An hourly. Why the jumping out?
Because Well, we got decreased back in 2015. We were decreased, and so I'm having a hard time finding somebody to take on a reduced hour part-time position for program assistant. I made an offer this past year because I had originally planned to have 20 hours of work a week, but I had to make an offer at 10 hours, and they declined the position. It's a position where we're trying to teach STEM programming through the 4-H programs and projects, and so, you know, it does require a little bit of knowledge in the STEM area. So anyway, we got turned down for it, and if we had more money. And the other thing that I was asking is to increase the hourly to $15 an hour, because I'm right now at, I think, $10.50. So I wanted to do that, so that would require more in the hourly also.
So you're looking to increase the hourly rate and the number of hours, and you anticipate that if that's approved, you will be at 27, 726?
Right.
Mm-hmm. All right, you guys have heard. What's your pleasure?
Are there raises in here, Netta?
There's salary raise that I asked for the two county full-time people, but I know that you're going to look at that at the end. So, and then we also had an increase in our contractual services of 1%.
So in your proposed budget, you don't have those increases in there, though, because the number's the same.
Right. That's right. Yeah.
I thought they...
You wrote that, yeah, you wanted $2,000 a piece for...
Right.
Salary
right.
The same.
Right. I requested, but I didn't, yeah, you're right. I didn't put it into the budget part.
Okay.
Because I know that usually comes out.
Okay, so we've got 243,161. We have a motion on that?
Yes.
You have a second on that? Second. Any further discussion?
On the... part-time hourly, we're saying there's an increase or a suggested increase?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
That's a maximum level. Is there more, is that higher than it has been?
Yes. Okay, so currently the hourly maximum that I have on my my budget is $10.50 an hour.
She wants to take that.
And so I want to be able to raise that to $16 an hour.
That
$16 for...
It went up a dollar in the last 5 minutes. Yeah. You got to get it out of here.
Well, I had listed it for one part-time position at $16 an hour and the 4-H program assistant at $15 an hour.
It's the fight for 15, Mike.
Yeah, and that's up from what?
$10.50.
So they're currently making...
$10.50.
And we're suggesting to go to 16.
Right.
For one.
I want to be able to go up to that, but I'm not planning on jumping them right up to that.
I mean, and here's the deal. I mean, we have two things here. One is it reasonable to for that position to expect 10, 15 an hour? And maybe the answer is yes. The second of all is it sometimes folks will come to us and say, I want to increase my hourly rate,
but not
go up over my hourly budget.
Right.
That's a little bit, you know, that's a different approach. It seems like she's doing a little bit of both.
Do you agree?
I just want to be able to do it.
Right.
You know, I'm not planning on starting people out at that rate, but depending upon their qualifications, I feel like I should be able to do that. Plus, last year, budget time, whenever I heard, I felt like I was the real miser because I was only paying $9 and $10 an hour, and a lot of people were paying much higher per hour. So. It just gives me a little flexibility.
Sure. Okay. Any further questions on this? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed? You're no longer a miser.
All right. Thank you.
Soil and water. Okay, so it's up a little bit. It looks like our increases, if I can read this, things like travel went up a little bit. Where's our big increase? Contractual services. So why is the contractual $5,000? What's that for?
We started a water testing program in northern Porter County. It's on the waters that flow into Lake Michigan. The dunes that takes the national lake, or national park, that takes care of monitoring whether people can swim in Lake Michigan after a storm event, are doing the water testing, and we're buying the supplies for it. They're providing the lab, the personnel that are educated and have experience in testing these types of water, and the facility and everything like that. It is figured that their services that they are providing is going to come up to over $100,000. And so far this year, we've paid almost $9,000 for supplies.
Is that something that we've always done?
No, we just started it.
Why?
The reason we started it was that in Iowa, at the Raccoon River, it furnishes drinking water for two towns. There has been an issue with nitrates and phosphates in the water, and they have to spend a lot of money to get those chemical or nutrients out of the water. Also, in 2012, there was an EPA testing program done in northern Porter County. They said that E. coli was high, and it was due to the fact that there was a lot of cattle in the area. And I imagine that a lot of you people live in northern Porter County, and you can come to Valparaiso from your home and never see an animal other than maybe a deer or something.
We have roosters.
Okay.
Just saying.
Wild turkeys?
Roosters in Chesterton, yeah, we have roosters.
Wow. That's really something, Jim.
Yeah.
thanks for enlightening us.
We're just going to...
And we want to continue on this in southern Porter County.
That's right.
And so that's why we need the extra money, because right now the people that are doing it
are doing it
to protect the lake, and so they can really put a lot more resources toward it. Well, when we move to the southern part of the county, or the waters that flow into the Kankakee River, then we'll have to have more supplies and
gotcha.
And more personnel.
Let me ask you a question. Is there an event that occurs that will trigger the testing?
It's done every month, started in March, at least once a month, and then whenever there's a rain event, that is at least 3/4 of an inch or more.
Well, with that in mind, have you taken this request to the Stormwater Board?
No, we haven't, and this is not stormwater event. This is water quality.
But it's runoff.
Not necessarily, because there could be natural things that happen that wouldn't be involved in it. When we get to southern Porter County, there'll be more agriculture. At this point in time in northern Porter County, we've got an area that has as close to no urban and no agriculture. Then we've got an urban area and an agriculture area. And they're testing three different sites in each of these three areas. When you get down to the southern part of the county, it's going to be different because you've got the farming practices that take place.
Is this for information only, what all this is about? Because
this is so that when a federal agency comes and says, you folks have a problem, we have a baseline to start from, and we have the work already done.
Okay.
Are there not any grants available to be?
There are not. That is something we have tried to find. It's impossible to find grants in order to purchase the reagents to do the chemistry.
So you got the national park doing the testing.
Correct.
You just have to collect the samples.
No, they collect the samples.
The only thing, we buy the supplies.
We just buy the supplies.
Where we would need the contractual employee is because when they run out of money, which they will, they're providing this as a summer intern program. When they run out of that money, October, November, December, we have to pick it up. And when we go to the southern part of the county, as Keith mentioned, that will be out of their jurisdiction. So they cannot provide labor if we're not sampling within the east branch of the Litoral-Cal, which is...
So who's going to do that then?
It would be this, well, we hope to have the same person. She's highly qualified. She's a PhD, has extreme experience in this field. So we'd like to retain her. She might find another job. We don't know. However, the Park Service, I'm sure, would be very capable of helping us.
Would you agree or not agree that stormwater plays a significant role here in the water quality that runs into tributaries that ends up in Lake Michigan?
Oh, sure. There's no doubt about that.
Okay, we can agree to that. Could we ask you before third reading to go to them, see what kind of reception you get about them, asking them to fund this, because it's relatively small. And I would certainly think that they would have it in their means to do it. I would appreciate that.
Well, I imagine the reason we haven't approached the Storm Board is because it's so new. And we started this study in March, and I believe the Stormwater Board...
Well, we have a member of the Advisory Stormwater Board.
Who's that?
Jeremy.
Jeremy.
Oh.
Before that, Jeremy?
Yeah, I mean, we can have this conversation. It's only $5,000, but one way or another, it's funded.
$20,000.
$15,000 for the supply.
$15,000 for the supply. $5,000 for that.
$20,000.
I mean, we, MS4, we have that program going, being funded through the whole stormwater fee. So we can have the conversation. One way or another, it'll get funded.
And because it is so new, I'm sure that there's still some seats on the bus to be had.
Well, we would hope so.
So I would appreciate it if you would approach them, maybe with Councilman Rivas's assistant, and see what kind of reception you get, and then come back and let us know.
I'll make the motion for 97216, last year's number, pending third reading, and see if they can work something out.
246.
Whatever,
97247.
Yeah, same as last year, until third reading.
That's a motion on the floor. Is there a second?
Second.
There's a second. Any further discussion?
Only question I have is regarding the cost. The proposed budget, does that include the county north and south completely?
Yeah.
The added $20,000, we're covering the north county through our the work that our group does. We get money from the state, and we get donations and this sort of thing. So we'll continue to do that, and that'll it depends on the number of rain events they have and how many supplies they use up in a year, but we'll cover that. This is just for the South County.
All right, well, you've heard the... Well, so if you could, reach out to the Drainage Board, as Councilman Biggs suggested. Like I said, we have a member of the Advisory Board here with us, so feel free to touch base with him as our liaison.
Okay.
And then we'll deal with it again on third reading, depending on what you come back with.
And for what it's worth, I'll call the department head that and tell them that I'm certainly in favor of them doing it.
Okay. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? The ayes have it. Thank you very much.
Good evening.
Treasurer. Well, matter of fact, hold on a second. We're going to bring the coroner up now. We're going back. Come on. This is going to be quick. Thank you, Mr. Coroner. It's good seeing you.
Thank you. Apologize about my tardiness.
So it looks like everything's the same, with the exception of a little bit of... When your overall budget is the same, but you've done a little bit of changing in the hourly.
Yes, I did add an employee, but the bottom line is to the penny what it was last year.
What's your pleasure with this budget?
Motion to approve.
Second. Motion in just a couple of seconds on the floor. Any discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
Treasurer. How are you, Michelle?
Hi.
So, a little bit of change, not much to your budget. Looks like you may have... What have you changed?
What did it change?
Raises. Salaries.
Yeah, salaries. Salaries went up.
The biggest portion of that is when I hired the chief deputy 2 years ago.
Yeah.
We reduced the salary, so she's actually making like 2,000 less than the rest of the staff because we brought her in new with no experience. I'd like to at least bump her up back even with the others. And then she also handles bankruptcies, and I think it'd be better served if she spent her time solely doing bankruptcies, which increases the burden than on the other two, which would be covering the windows and the phone and the mail and everything else.
Okay, you've heard the treasurer's request. Okay. Do you want to back those out to our salary discussion, or do you want to deal with it now?
I'd back them up.
Yeah, I think we have to
do that with all.
Yeah, we have to do it with all of them.
So take those out and give us a number.
Yeah, other than that, it's the same.
I mean, it's a little bit different. But, I mean, I think you make sure you remind us. I mean, she lowered the salary when she brought somebody in new.
Right.
So,
Vicki, if you would, you know, if you see something like that, maybe we can keep track.
Oh, yes.
And then we'll come back and deal with it directly. Okay. So the number's the same. Can I get a motion to that?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Thank you. That's it. You too now. I guess Opportunity Enterprise still is not here. Tourism.
Slow down.
Couple changes. Make your proposal.
Well, the obvious issue is this reduction in the venues. And
what? Reduction in the venues.
Oh. And that was anticipated from last year. We discussed it last year. The issues are still the same this year. The purpose of those reserve funds are to keep us within the standards of what's required to operate tourism when we don't have money coming in. And here's the instances where we don't have money coming in. For instance, right now, our lease is on the verge of expiring with the national park. We've had that happen either the budget wasn't approved nationally or our lease has expired previously, and during negotiations, until there's an active lease, the feds don't pay. Now, eventually, we get that money back. They eventually pay once the lease is approved, but they withhold payment during that entire time. That's happened for a year twice. The other thing is we're funded, as you know, through the bed tax, basically, through the statute that provides for funding of tourism. And that's not a sure thing, and that's a thing that's fluctuating. When they were working at BP and everybody...
Let me just stop you right there and ask you a quick question.
Sure.
So your proposal, I mean, at one time you were 89.1 to the venues. We got you up to 150. You're proposing now 100.
Correct.
Would you do 100, which is something better than 100?
Yes, I think we will. But I think I wanted to set out my board's concerns because it's important for us to grow this fund, and as a result of last year, we were unable to.
Okay.
We have one other issue that's coming up, and I want to make you aware of it now. Under the Fair Labor Standards Act, as you probably know,
we have heard such things.
They've raised the threshold rate for professionals. Well, all of our employees are professionals, our whole staff. So we're going to have to look at that at some point between now and the first of the year, so we're going to be back here.
Why?
Well, because we're going to need to increase salaries.
Why?
When?
Why?
Why? Because we're not, because...
Just because it's the threshold went to 47.3, we're all going to give raises?
Everybody gets 47.3?
Yeah.
That's going to be a tough argument in December.
Well, our money doesn't come out of the general.
Don't talk to me about where your money comes from. It's tax money. Okay, if it comes out of, you know, the magic pill.
Well.
And that'll be a horse for running another day. But, and we can have that discussion in detail about where your professionals fall and how that fits in the FLSA at that time, I suppose. Okay.
That's an upcoming issue for us.
Yep, yep. So,
We're willing to go to 120. I can do that.
Look, 125, not here. I thought I heard 125, my ears.
No, I mean, I'm trying to be reasonable and I'm trying to compromise. The clear message last year from all of you was that that was a one-time deal, that we were going up from 89.1. We thought when we were putting the budget together that in the spirit of supporting the venues, which we do support the venues, both individually and as an entity, that we should increase it to 100. So we thought that was a generous move, and then to quibble over that now is a little embarrassing for me.
How is that embarrassing?
That was probably the absolute wrong thing to say.
Maybe not embarrassing.
You probably want to turn back the hands of time about a minute.
Maybe not embarrassing, but it just makes me uncomfortable because
I don't know. Mitch, I get that, and I'm just going to jump in here for just a second. I appreciate your, I know your thoughts, I appreciate the fact that you're saying you've up to 120. I view the venues as an opportunity for partnering with tourism. I see the venues as something that might bring people into town, bring people into the county. I mean, we've had shows at the Opera House that brought people in from out of county. I see that as an opportunity for you, not as a liability for you.
And so, I'll address that.
So
that you're allocating at 100,000, we're allocating 9%.
Let me finish. So what I'm saying to you is, as we work through this, and I'm okay with your 120, by the way. But the fact of the matter is, I think that when you say things like, it's embarrassing for us to quibble, I want you to understand that I find that obnoxious. That the fact of the matter is, this is an opportunity. It's an opportunity for the venues, and it's an opportunity for tourism. And I've told you that I think that we ought to have tourism out there with these venues getting some credit for this, because a lot of people don't know that. They don't know that you guys have contributed to the venues, and I think they should know, because I think that is something that does help with some tourism. Not, maybe not your total mission statement, but it certainly has something to do with tourism.
Absolutely. And when I say I'm embarrassed, I'm just embarrassed personally that I'm even here arguing.
Well, here's what
I don't mean to disparage the board.
Yeah, I understand. You're the board attorney. I would much rather hear from Lorelei than the board.
He's the president of the board.
The president of the board. You're still an appointment.
Yes.
I want to hear the person that county government, the taxpayers hired to run that department, and not a board appointment.
Well, let me just jump in here for 1 second. I don't disagree with that generally. Two things, though. He's the president of the board, and he's our appointment. So
he's not my appointment.
Well, as long as you sit on the county council, he is.
I didn't vote for him.
So, okay. Well, there's a lot of things I didn't vote for, but I take ownership of because I go with the body. But the fact of the matter is, Lorelei, do you have anything additional to say?
No, I think Mitch has said it.
Do you have questions of Lorelei? Jim?
Yes, I think that I don't agree with the amount for life to the venue. I think it should be substantially increased, to be very honest with you. Because I think that those venues, if operated properly, funded properly rather, that they are a big draw, which is what the tourism is all about. That's my feeling. And since we're on the subject matter, I would appreciate hearing more from you than your board president. Okay?
Absolutely. And I do remember, if you guys remember several years ago, our board put the venues to zero. I don't know if you remember when I got to have that conversation, but part of it was the pressure that the board gets, that we have communities that have parks and theaters and you know, there's all these other businesses that are looking to us for promotion. So that's been the other argument. So we've been in that side of it as well, when other communities are like, it's not fair that the other communities can't come forward and compete for those same funds when their parks are bringing in those same things as well. So that was, you know, that's.
You're helping us with county, the Memorial Opera House, the, you know, things that.
Expo, the parks.
Yeah, right, and I think that, in all fairness, I'd like to see it remain the same as it was.
Well, I agree.
Maybe for everybody's edification, if you could send us a list of where your venue money went last year. Just, you know.
I find that very helpful.
Yeah.
Not money?
Well, not the county stuff. I mean, the Port Fest, I'll use that as an example, did you give money to the Port Fest or something?
It's the same thing you guys did last year, I believe.
Yeah, yeah, we have a grant.
Yeah.
Did you use all of that grant money? Did you give it all out?
We earmark it all out, but it's up to the festivals to spend it. So some of them may not spend all the money that they've requested, so we can't control that. But if we, you know, earmark $50,000, we can't earmark more than that because we know potentially up to $50,000.
I was on the board at one time and I vaguely remember that there was some of the money that was, wasn't always totally earmarked out.
Here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna set this over. Because we have a split decision here. And I think that what you need to do is get us a list of where your money's going, give us an opportunity to review it, and we're gonna have to do this.
So it, our money, so if you all received our strategic plan, the budget is in there. It breaks down the pie in terms of what is operational, what is administration, what is venue and grants, as well as what is marketing.
So if I were in your shoes, Lorelei, and I mean this as a friendly piece of advice, I would go on the I'll get it to you right away approach.
Oh, absolutely.
As opposed to the already gave it to you approach.
No, and absolutely, and I would also welcome everyone to sit down with me individually to go over what we're doing, so you have you understand really what we're doing on the promotional side and the light, the positive light we are shining on Porter County in terms of outside the area, which is significant because it does have an overall impact in traditional economic development as well.
And by the way, I don't think that the discussion tonight is whether or not you're doing a good job. I think the question tonight is, what's an appropriate amount to go, from our perspective, to the venues? So we can either vote on this tonight and revisit it at third reading, or would you guys like me to set the second reading over? Sounds to me like
one way or the other.
Either way, we're going to have to come back to them.
It's only just, I mean, it's the second reading. It's just the second reading.
Right. But we're going to start putting a lot on the plate for our third reading.
I say take it to 120. That's what Mitch tossed out, and make the motion. We do the numbers.
Second.
120, and we do the numbers, and we'll get back to it on third reading. Keep it moving.
All right, so there's a motion and a second. If it's 120, I don't know if it's going to pass, but there's if we put in 120 to the venues, what does that make the bottom line?
828,920.
Shade more than that.
Yes. 1,372,652.
Is that the motion?
Yeah, I'll make that. Keep it moving.
Second, concur?
Yes.
Just for fun, let's have a roll call on this.
Roll call. Okay. Councilmember Conover?
Yes.
Councilmember Bitt?
No.
Okay. Councilmember Grant?
No.
Councilmember Jessen?
Yes.
Councilmember Papera?
No.
Councilmember Rebus?
Yes.
And Councilmember Britton.
You just voted no to your own motion?
Yeah, I just wanted to keep it moving here.
Well, then why didn't you do a motion to deny? Okay.
I will vote.
What's the count? I've lost count.
Well, right now it's three.
Yes. Yes. So let's just look at, but we're going to revisit this number on third reading. We're going to, I want to.
Do we have that scheduled now, or?
Yeah, what is our third reading? What's our third reading?
Number 27th, I think.
October 27th.
So on October 27th, by then, I encourage, if you guys...
We'll get you everything you asked for.
Sounds good.
And so let you guys leave on a good note. Mitch, I really like your tie.
Thank you very much, Jeremy.
Have a good evening.
I appreciate that.
Motion to deny.
Assessor.
Councilmember Conover?
We have a motion on the floor to deny.
I'll second it.
Yeah.
I withdraw my motion. I want to hear what he has to say first. Well, you came in here wearing a Cubs.
Oh, I'm sorry. All right, so it looks like, so let's get into this a little bit. So we have the county assessor's budget, general fund, 10-09. So it's gone up a little bit, and that's because of contractual?
That's correct.
Gone up.
We talked, when I was in sometime in August, about my department's need for pictometry. And I think at that time, we had eliminated a position, but I put the council on notice that we were hopeful to gain that money back for budgetary purposes for pictometry. So.
When's the last, is this the flyover, the cost of doing a flyover?
That's correct, yes. About $100,000 a year.
All right.
How much was it?
$100,000 a year.
And when's the last time, you told me already, John, but refresh my memory. When's the last time we did it?
It's been more than 2 years.
And they recommend every couple of years?
Yes, that's correct.
But we still have field inspectors?
We've eliminated a lot of our field inspectors. I mean, we have a couple, but we used to have 12. So I did a cost analysis from eliminating 12 positions at a half of the normal hours per year, which is 2,080. I ran it at 1,040 hours at $12 an hour, and it's a savings of $125,000, and that's a pretty conservative estimate from what it's saved us on an annual basis.
Well, I mean, we need to keep our pictometry up to date because that helps with assessments, and we don't have, you know, it helps prevent scoff laws.
That's correct.
For lack of a better term, so we do need to be up to date on that.
That's correct, yeah.
Well, I agree with that. I guess I'm wondering, I don't want to say what's the point of the field inspectors, but if they fly over and see the pole barn you illegally built then what do we need to do?
We're still required by state statute to send field inspectors to the properties, but in this case it's a much more expedited trip to the property. We can also see backyards where we can't see them. Long driveways. There's several spots in the county up in Beverly Shores that we can't get to, you know, Ogden Dunes. It just gives us a view of the entire property many times that we can't see from boots on the ground.
Well, no, I agree with pictometry. I'm still questioning why we have field people. Well, I understand that. I understand what he said. I don't know if I agree with it.
We're also chasing permits with our field people. When I'm saying that we're tracking new construction that we can't do, waiting every 2 years, we need to keep up with it on a...
You mean there's no coordination between you and the building department on permits?
I'm sorry?
You know, another way pulls if people don't have a permit.
Huh?
I think what he's talking about, like, let's say for example...
When you build a pole barn with no permit?
Yeah.
Okay.
So maybe some tree line, you're not sure...
Did you catch that on a flyover?
All right.
Yeah. Correct. They actually provide software that it's an overlay of the first flyover, you overlay the second flyover, and it'll catch, it's called Change Finder, so it finds all the changes over, I think, 100 square feet, so decks, pole barn, sheds.
Okay, I mean, I agree with all that, I'm just still...
Because sometimes things need the boots on the ground.
Correct.
But maybe it's not definite in the flyover, maybe it's, maybe they can't see.
That's correct, yes. Yeah, the state requires us to still physically visit these properties.
Do you have any other questions open, Bob?
John, who's the...
It's a circular argument.
Other than your office, who's the other end users on this?
Right.
Yeah, we talked about that before, and I didn't bring the list with me, but we've identified about a dozen different departments. They all claim that they don't use it anymore, but I shouldn't say they all. We had to turn off online access because of the lack of funding, and we had several departments contact us to say, when is this going to come back? And I said, contact the council. So I don't know if you've had any calls or not, but I think of Valpo Fire.
Yeah, we tell them to contact the assessor.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
I think Portage is here tonight, Chesterton, several different departments and municipalities are using this. We make it available to them. So.
But they rely on it?
I don't know if they'd say they rely on it, but they do utilize it as a tool. Valpo Fire wanted to use it for the popcorn festival. They can see alleyways and, you know,
So right now online they can't access it to...
No, it's off.
It's off,
yes.
Okay.
John, you said the total cost is $100,000?
Yeah, it's approximately $100,000 a year.
So is your budget actually going to cover all that, or where's the rest?
Well, we're asking for approximately $50,000 in the general fund to cover that, and then $50,000 out of reassessment, which we'll get to here in a minute, and I can explain that with Vicki's help a little bit. So.
Dan, can I circle back for a second?
Sure.
We have the data.
from the flyover, but Valpo Fire, for example, is not allowed access. Is there...
Can you just shut it off?
Well, is there a cost to it?
There is an annual cost to the online service.
Okay.
They can come to our office. We invited them to come.
Okay, so they still have access to it, just a little inconvenient.
Yeah, that's correct.
How much is it for online?
I think that's $5,000-$6,000 a year to have, and we have, I can't remember the list again, Bob, but I think it's 50 to 60 people that that's giving access to, and it can grow, the list can grow. It doesn't, it's not a per-user fee, it's just a...
Flat fee.
A flat fee, yes.
I mean, and I'm not going to defend Valpo Fire, they just happen to be the subject of conversation. We have a $40 million budget, we don't have $5,000 to allow all the other municipalities access to this information?
Well, they will. I mean, the assessor's office will provide it as part of our...
Somebody has to come in here. I mean...
No, they do now because our online access has been shut down because of the funding issue.
Right, so okay. You said it's fine.
So he's asking if you know, why don't we get it back up and running?
We will, as soon as we get this approved. They're going to fly, they would like to fly this fall after the leaves are out of the trees, so we're...
So what he's saying is, if we get this, we do this, it gets updated, they're back online.
Right, but it's offline right now is my question.
And this is for next year.
But it's offline because of the $5,000 or $6,000?
That's correct, yes.
That's what I'm talking about. I mean, it may be old data, but it's still data.
They can still access that data, as we talked about.
Oh, they can still access the old data.
They can. They have to come to our terminal.
No, but that's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about.
He's wondering, why don't we, if it's just a $5,000 cost a year, why don't we allow remote access?
Yeah, well, give
me $5,000.
Right, it's just the timing of how all this works and when the payments are due. There's payments due now that we're not going to make until we know what our next year budget is.
And your anticipation is that if we approve this, it will be available to them?
Yes, they've told us they will hold invoicing until next year on some of these things. Like, they will allow things to start, but encumber the funds for next year, if I understand what I'm saying.
And I appreciate it. I guess I'm disappointed that for $5,000, Valpo Fire has been shut off, even though I know it's outdated data, but, I mean, come on, $40 million budget, I mean, we don't have $5,000 to let other municipalities have access to it. I find that a little disappointing.
It's just $5,000 out of my budget.
It's $5,000 out of county budget.
No, this is, the assessor's budget would pay the $5,000.
Okay. But I didn't know you had your own budget, I thought it was like the county budget, you know.
Well,
you know what
he's saying. Do you want to look at his budget currently right now?
Listen, in front of us.
Maybe we can find the $5,000 right now.
Mitch had it.
I have one more question.
Okay,
yes, sir.
Go ahead.
John, you ever have any outside companies, individuals, from the private sector come in and ask for that information?
We do, yes.
Do we charge them?
We do not, no.
Well, there you go.
I don't think we're allowed. I think that the agreement that we have with the flying company out of Rochester, New York, Pictometry, I don't think that they allow, for some reason, I don't think they allow us to charge. I don't know. There's some kind of a technicality there because we've looked into that before.
I don't understand. We're buying that information. We're not renting.
There might be proprietary lenses, and it's a high-tech flying system.
I don't understand why they would re-research that, John, see if it's a possibility.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
It might be a way to raise some revenue.
I'll be more than glad to give them $5,000.
Can you turn that back on? Come to us for an additional?
Yeah. We'll find $5,000 for the end of the
I think that they would turn it back on.
I'm talking to you personally.
That would be a $98,000 bill.
I think we're probably going to. So.
We're moving a little bit to the silly stage here. All right, so here we go. We got in front of a 776-351. What is your plan?
Move.
We have a motion.
Second.
And a second. Further discussion?
Yeah.
Is this going to turn them back on?
Yes.
Thank you.
I do. I don't know. I'm looking at it in front of me. Maybe I've missed it so far. But there's $22,000 for contractual attorney. Hasn't this county moved towards like a...
Do you still have an attorney?
Yes, he sits in at Pete Aboa hearings.
Who's doing it right now?
It's Christopher Buckley, and then John Buscemi out of Lake County. I forget where he's from.
You know what, Jeremy makes a good point.
The whole idea of Scott.
The whole idea was the law department.
As long as Scott knows that I'm coming. Because we do use attorney.
Why don't we try that? Why don't we try to see how that goes?
Well, you'd have to have the approval of the Board of Commissioners to allow their employee to do that.
Well, isn't this kind of what we've talked about?
I would, yeah, but I think the Board of Commissioners need our permission to have the money.
They may be fully in support of it, I just say, you have to ask them.
Why don't we take the 22 out, and then by third reading, get an answer to that question?
Fine.
I'm just making.
I agree.
Take the $22,000 out.
Okay, if you combine that with the prior savings, then I think it's a break even, really, or a little better to the county, but.
We like that kind of talk. And then, in the meantime, I'll, and by the way, just to let you know, I have talked to the commissioners, and I have talked to Scott McClure, and he's trying to develop the legal department, and he's been giving up a lot of the work, and I think that in our discussion, this was one of the departments that he was looking to bring under.
You may want to have led with that, though.
I forgot.
Have we missed any other previous?
I don't think so.
With this one there?
Tourism.
Tourism.
Chairman reminded me.
Tourism. Matt, I add one more thing, too, that I met with Mr. Wellsand today, IT, I don't know if he's interim or not, I can't recall what.
He got appointed, permanent.
Okay, so our IT director, we talked about some savings as well with computers and things, so I am working towards further reducing my budget, so.
Excellent.
Excellent.
So the new number without the attorney is $754,351, what's your pleasure?
Approve.
Approve, yes.
Motion is second, all in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, I will revisit with the commissioners and with Scott. And that, the reason I didn't leave with that is it's kind of an older conversation.
Senior moment.
It is, I have those. Is that what I have to look forward to?
Do I get Scott's bat phone number now?
Yes.
Okay, good, thank you.
All right. Reassessment.
Reassessment, we talked to the auditor. One thing that we've been good at as far as budgeting out of that fund is we haven't asked for any increases, I believe, over 6 years. And so, but the state also cut this fund because of a lower levy, if I'm explaining this correctly. So Vicki felt like we're in a good position now that we could ask for an increase of 50 grand pretty easily. The fund can absorb it, and it doesn't really change the outlook as far as the county goes. I understand that it is taxpayer money.
Is that for the back half of the pictometry? Is that?
Yes, this is there for the other 50,000. So we would ask for more from out of this fund, and it shouldn't even be noticed.
Makes sense. What's your pleasure?
Move. Second.
Motion and a motion and a second and a second. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed. Board of Assessor. Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you.
So Alta, looks like you are the same.
For my general.
Yes. So what's your pleasure with the Portage Assessor's General Fund budget?
Move to approve.
We have a motion.
Second.
And a second. Discussion? Numbers the same, 211,896. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed. Portage Reassessment. This one's a shade more? What are we doing here?
I have a part-timer that I want to make her full-time, because our reassessment is ongoing consistently. So she does a great job, so I want to go ahead and make her full-time.
How's this fund doing?
Okay, one thing I have to point out, even though these are two different department heads, we share the same reassessment fund. So when John was talking about how we worked on the levy, okay, we have to combine both of these funds for purposes of.
So let me ask you this.
So what's the fund doing?
Let me ask you this, yes. How's that fund doing?
Right now we have a balance of $334,000, almost $335,000. They do get a share of the property taxes and see the.
Right.
So we're going to see a boom come in December.
So, okay. What's your pleasure?
Move.
We have a motion and a second. Any discussion?
Nope.
If they go full-time, they're also put on benefits.
Benefits, but any extra money I had, I transferred over to, so the extra money I'm asking for really is covering the, what I'm short of for the medical and PERF and FICA. But I have been made aware of something tonight, well, this afternoon. I need an extra $10,000
Why?
Dan?
Yeah, my surprise. Well, it was, the level two and the level three, for my office was being paid out of the reassessment fund, but out of John's, budget.
Thank you, John.
So now we're just, switching it over to mine, so I need to have an increase of $10,000, because I have.
In your reassessment?
Yeah.
All right.
Did we see a decrease in John's budget then, from that?
You'll have to tell John.
It's only second reading.
Thank you, you know that.
So, this part-time position you're talking about, wanting to take full-time.
Mm-hmm.
Because they're part-time, has that caused a problem?
No, no, it hasn't, but since it's an ongoing, position, and she does a great job, you know, and I don't want to lose her, you know, for any other reason, you know.
How many hours has she been working?
Just 29 hours a week.
Do you have need of a full-time employee? You need of her going, see, it's not enough to say, she's doing a really good job as a part-time employee, so I just want to add her onto the role as a full-time employee, because she's really cool. We need to know that you need a full-time employee, and I think that's what Jim's probably getting to.
Well, yeah, because she does more than just the reassessment. When we have permits, we send her out. If we need a property looked at for an appeal, we send her out.
But that's all folded into that 29 hours, isn't it?
Correct.
So, can she not get a lift done in 29 hours, I guess is what he's trying to get to a long way around.
Let's start from the very beginning. That's a very fine place to start. Why do you need a full-time employee?
Because she does full-time work.
In 29 hours.
Yes, but she only works 4 days a week. We could use her on five.
But the job is getting done right now, working part-time.
Correct.
But you have need of her to be full-time.
Correct. We could use the extra day.
So I guess maybe it's in the presentation.
Right.
Try this a different way. So you have somebody
who would like to sit over there and talk.
Oh, I'm sorry. So what we need in the reassessment, so you have, are you telling us that there is additional work that she could be doing that she's not getting done in 29 hours, and that is why you need her to be full-time?
And honestly, no.
Please be honest.
That's it.
She did say no.
I'm very sure
no.
That's right.
So
I would be more inclined to give her a little more money hourly if you wanted something like that.
So let me try to rephrase the question.
She already answered it, Dan.
Ask
and answer.
It's true. I mean, but I appreciate her.
You want to give her a little bit more money?
So this is all I have for her.
Okay. So
how about if we increase the hourly?
Yeah, I can appreciate that and understand it. I'm just speaking for myself. I think because of the cost involved, this is not, and I'm talking about this year, the request for a new full-time employee is not, the timing is not the best. But I can tell you, I'm very, very impressed with your
office. Vicki, how much has she been using all of her hourly?
I think my hourly only went up the total cost would have only went up $8,000.
Right, I want to see.
Like I said, I'm just recently learning about the extra $10,000 because.
Right.
So it looks like you're probably burning up the $26,000. Well, close.
And she's at your maximum of $12 per hour currently?
No, right now she's at $17.
Is that conflicting with the bottom of that? Well, let me ask you a question, Board.
Board?
Yeah, well, before you get to that question, I have a question.
You know what I'm going to ask?
No, but you just said that she's making 17, but it looks like your 144 says up to 12 per hour.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, that must be from an older one. No, that's not correct. Okay. That's not correct. It's an error I didn't catch.
Okay. So now the question.
My question is not to you, but to the board. If we were not to bump her to full-time, but allowed her to pay her up to 18 an hour and keep her at part-time. Mm-hmm. Just, give us this year, mm-hmm. and then we'll come back and revisit this.
Yeah, the only struggle I'd have with that at this point is that the sheet that we're looking at shows the maximum is $12.
Well, is there, Vicki, is there, do you have any record there that shows whether or not?
What is the hourly right now that you're paying?
That must have been an error on the form, because the salary ordinance does say $15 to $20 per hour.
Okay.
She's already asked.
She can already, she can do it on, we shouldn't even need to do us to do anything, she could take it to $18, or, right now.
She could?
Yeah, because she's up to $20 right now, she could go up to $20.
Per the salary ordinance.
Yeah.
Is there a way we can ensure that we have proper information in front of us so it matches the salary ordinance?
Somehow, some way?
Because this information is meaningless to us.
Well.
I'll tell you.
This is what was turned in, though, so.
Over the last couple of years, have you cut any employees?
Oh, yeah, I gave back, when I first took office, I gave back about $27,000, because I eliminated position. So what I do now with my reassessment person, I have one person, I have my part-timer and a full-time person go out, they take turns in the office. Right now, the situation that we're in right now, I'm noticing that our older neighborhoods, instead of being reassessed every 4 years, are having to be reassessed 2 years. So I don't have enough manpower for that, so while she's out with someone, I have to take another employee myself, and starting first of the year, we have to start going out and I have to start looking at these older neighborhoods, because the grades are starting to change, because people are remodeling.
You yourself, you're going out?
Mm-hmm, I have to.
John, you go out, you put boots on the ground?
I have to.
Often is it?
No, this is, it's become a necessity, I have a significant amount of sales where properties are being remodeled, and the grade that they're at now doesn't stand, you know, so I have to upgrade.
Yeah.
So, but I have to get out there, and the only way I can do that is if they appeal or during reassessment. So I have to get out there starting first of the year.
So what's your pleasure with this budget, guys? Let's just move.
I guess we're taking the 37,000 salary out, and we're making it up to a $20 an hour wage.
Is somebody there?
Well, it's not here, it's on my computer now.
It's in the salary ordinance.
Yeah.
I will second that.
So we take the $20,000 off the $92,000. But she also mentioned $10,000, you need another $10,000 put in this budget?
For the levels, yes.
And what line item would that be under?
I was told to put it under the full-time, the first page of the reassessment, under reassessment specialist. Six of us are level two, and by the end of the year, myself and three other ones will be a level three.
So we're changing level three amount to what?
They each get it'll be a total of $4,000 for level three, and a total of $6,000 for level two.
Because insurance is going to be a big push.
How many level
so
twos
what's
you
the
have?
Bottom line, Vicki?
All six of us are level twos, but I'm the only one with the level three. My three, I have three full-time
so
employees.
You get
we got to take the medical out too, right? Because we're not.
You will have to take the medical out. You have to take the medical and the perf out.
Right.
So you'd be taking out 21.5.
All right. Dan, I'm a little confused, Mr. President.
Yes, Bob.
I'm confused. Everybody's level two.
Mm-hmm.
So why do we have $1,000? Do you get $1,000 for being level three, and then $6,000 for being level two?
Each person gets a level. It gets $1,000 for the level two, plus $1,000 for the level three. And as currently, I'm the only one in the office who has the level.
No, wait a minute. Okay, so you got everybody's level two. They all get $1,000.
Right.
And you get how much?
An extra $1,000, $2,000, because okay. I have a level two and three.
Okay. Okay. Cool.
We'll fuck it there.
All right, so the new number would be 67,034.
I'll make the motion.
We have a motion on the floor. A second. Discussion? All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? The ayes have it.
Can we take a quick break?
Yes.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you for being so honest.
Oh, yeah, no problem.
Appreciate it.
Can we clarify, did you change the hourly to $26,000?
No, she's asking a different question.
Oh, I'm sorry, okay.
Hourly as it was last year.
Come on.
Yeah. But then you'll have to take out medical.
Happy birthday.
Yes.
Yes.
No, 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 we have to do first all of that.
Okay.
Level 23 comes out.
No, we don't have that.
Because it's like.
I get it.
And that's why we also have to just find the last.
Oh, my God.
I need to get it for you, that's.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Awesome, I tried.
I know. But, yeah.
I got your text earlier, so.
Oh, okay, yeah.
I'll call you.
Okay. But if you're, you only do what the.
I made 24 grand.
Yes, I'll have three by the end of the year, so the first of the year starts. So that's why I wanted to approve it. The $10,000.
Wasn't it?
Yeah.
It was shot, yeah. So we got some money to start my.
That's right, yeah.
So you need.
I just, I have a.
Four level three, but there's only one level.
Yes, but they're all three, I'll have by the end of the year, so I need to be in the first of the year.
Four.
That's why I said I need $10,000.
I know.
Can we.
We gave it a run.
Can we have the, look at these numbers? I think the wrong number is right at the end.
Well, all right.
We can do that every day.
Yeah.
You gave the $10,000 level two.
So it's submitted to us. Their last year's budget, and then they proposed this year's budget. Who checks to make sure that they're proposing this way?
We always check the salary, well, whatever they turn in is what they turn in. But we always check the salary to make sure that it's in agreement with the salary ordinance or any changes that you made during the course of the year. So this is a last minute note, we just got this revision today because she didn't know that it was taken out.
Mike had said, how do we do this, these numbers are meaningless, I don't think that's exactly true.
Oh, absolutely not.
I think we need to clarify.
And also, we didn't know about the $10,000. This is what we got right before the meeting.
Gotcha.
Right before.
So we'll clarify.
And this is what we got here that set up.
No problem, I'm with you.
$10,000. So we have no idea if Alter wants to reduce it to $12,000 an hour next year.
Thank you for joining us.
I don't think.
Welcome to the scenario where everyone was. But, okay, so what happened was, when whoever was in the story, I think it's a cold, or just a story, and I think we did last year, which was the hourly last year.
Yeah.
So I think that's what we need, one for each day.
That's why we need everything to go through our office.
No. She just told them.
I have a.
She is a lot of work.
Number. the last minute, whatever the last, whatever. It was just, yeah, an old, $3,400.
Yeah, but I didn't, is what I'm saying. But this one I first got, when I got in June, but this is the one I got in June.
The one that was modified today.
Uh-huh.
And this still, not the one, because you didn't send it over.
Right, no, right, I did. Okay.
Tell me what my number is.
But I can see what I'm seeing now.
And also, who was this part-time person that?
We'll check right now. We'll check what exactly.
I believe if we go back to the $1,000, remember you made some changes. Okay, in last year's 144, I mean, down here, we had part-time of 13, but I think there was a change in the year.
But of course, so she's quite, Connie's got to talk to our women.
Maybe. Yeah, right, so far, not so far. All right, let's keep going here. Recorder. Okay, to clarify, I just want to clarify, that when people submitted their budgets, our auditor was good enough to go through and make sure that the numbers were correct on the, for last year's budget. And then we have a proposal for this year's budget, and then the auditor did also go through and run an analysis on any additionals that we may have had to do. So we have an accurate picture of what it really cost us last year for a particular line item. There was a little bit of confusion with that last budget because it was submitted, it was changed last minute, and apparently an old form was used. But, so Vicki, if we have any other budgets that have come in after you've had the opportunity, just let us know, and we'll go through them.
And same here, let us know too. There's been some budgets submitted that we don't see at the last minute, and they come in. For example, there's 10,000, we didn't even know.
Well, we didn't know either.
The budget we were given actually says that $12 an hour pay. And it only had
Well, just to be clear, you found out.
Reassessment.
Yeah, you found out about that the same moment we did. Because I didn't get that.
Just before the meeting.
Yeah, that's when we got it.
Yeah, so we're about ready to hear something that you have not seen. I would appreciate knowing.
And tell us. I haven't seen it.
And we won't hear it until you see it.
Okay. We're with you. And vice versa.
There were last budget hearings, there were some last minute changes as well, and that's where that mistake was made, where we didn't pull the department sitting right there. And they know it, I've apologized, where we missed the salary ordinance we approved were correct. We gave everyone the $1,000 rate, but in the line item, we missed it because it happened at the very last minute, and there just wasn't enough time to do it. I mean, we are trying to do our
This is. Vicki, this is not at all a criticism on the work you're doing. This is merely me saying if someone comes in and gives us a last minute budget, we'll tell you and you tell us, and we'll make sure that we won't hear it if we have to put it over.
John Wayne said, never say you're sorry.
It's a sign of weakness. Recorder. So it looks like you're doing some things here. You're pulling some out of perpetuation, is that correct?
Yes. And I'd be happy to explain why.
Sylvia and I met with John last year,
right?
And the perpetuation fund is drying up, and he's been doing this in increments. He started last year, this is this year, and I think next year will be the final.
Well, if we can. The problem we've had is the perpetuation fund, not only the perpetuation fund, but the redaction fund, those two funds are bleeding to death.
Right.
And I know right now we're talking about general fund, but... I mean, I've got the numbers here. The perpetuation fund in 1 year, because of statutory changes, the biggest reason what's happening is we used to sell copies at $1 a piece.
Right.
We now have to sell bulk copies at 7 cents a piece, and we only have two clients. So you're looking at a dollar. Instead of getting a dollar now, we're getting 14 cents. And that, in 1 year, we lost $90,000 a year of income right there, where we used to get, last year we got a full amount on the old fees was $157,000, it dropped to $61,000, and it stays right around there. In 2011, the redaction fund, we used to get $1 per document for redaction, we're now getting 25 cents. So that's a 75 cent loss there.
So they're bleeding. So right now, the proposal is to try to sort of segue.
If we.
So you've heard his proposal, what's your pleasure with recorder's?
We're just moving.
Right.
One other thing I'd like to say is also, we had one person leave last year, and we found that the office has been able to function pretty well, very well.
Good.
So we don't need to, we removed the salary and benefits from the budget right there, so.
I'll make a motion. We have a motion on the floor and a second. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed, the ayes have it. Let's go to perpetuation. Same thing. So what's your pleasure with perpetuation at 155? We have a motion.
Second.
And a second. Discussion? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed. Recorder redaction, $15,000.
I'll make the motion.
Second.
Motion and second. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed. The ayes have it. All right, John.
So just for my clarity, because I'm getting old.
It happens to the best of us.
No, you're not, John.
And bald. You're not catching me on that, though. So these, the budgets as presented, I presented, those have been all accepted. Thank you very much, I appreciate it.
On second reading.
You're back.
I trust, that's better than a no, I appreciate it, thank you.
There's always somebody who wants to.
I know.
I see that.
Thank you for the consideration.
Have a good evening, my man. ITS.
It's, what's it?
So what we're doing here, and I've talked to, I got a call from Commissioner Blaney this evening, and what they've done is they've created this print shop budget, and that's because they want to keep track of who's,
in the print shop.
Who's using the print, who's using these services, I guess, or how, keep better track of how it's being, spent down. So they pulled it out of ITS and into a print shop, double X. The numbers are the same, I believe, or close.
No, they are the same.
Yeah, so I'm just trying to do the math. 57,000 plus 405 is not the same.
Off $2,000 somewhere.
So just to clarify that, we're close, but there's a couple thousand difference. But what I was told was that you're just moving it over.
They just want to create a, have the print shop create its own budget.
We're past that. I just wonder where the other 2,000 is. What am I missing?
I don't know. Supplies is up, what, 450, but.
Do what? Travel?
Why is there even a travel line item in print shop?
For print?
She doesn't go anywhere.
Take it out.
Take it out.
I should start with, yeah.
Mileage in the building.
I guess.
So let's do this. Let's take 750 out of travel for the print shop.
Sure they deliver.
And do you use the travel in ITS?
Yes, we do.
Okay.
We drive from Gulf of the Portage quite a bit.
All right. All right, so if we take the 750 out of the
print shop,
and then it's, I see you went up 500 bucks on printing other than office supply. Is that just some?
Oh, that's
where the other 500.
Yeah.
Or another 500, please. Or 450.
It is rounded off.
Was the intention to just take it?
Just to move it.
Move it up. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. I want you to take 750 out of the print shop, and I want you to take, in the print shop, printing other than office supply, take that down to $14,550. Now, what's that number?
$55,800.
All right. Now, take $460,883 minus that number. Put that up there.
$401,083.
All right. What's your pleasure?
That's my motion.
On both?
Second.
Yep, both. I was doing both same time.
All right, motion and a second on both. Does everybody understand what we're doing here? All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed.
That's it.
Thank you. Have a good night.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Auditor.
Or do you want to hold yours to the last, Vicki, since you've got to be here?
Yeah.
We have to see yours last. Is yours GIS, I don't know, I said jail lease rental?
I'll make that motion. Not much discussion about that.
No. Is there a second?
Second.
How many years are left?
Oh.
Just curious.
Let me look that up, I haven't.
Health Department, you want to come up while we're... While she's looking that up, we're going to skip over to the Health Department. Let's just keep on trucking.
2024.
24?
Thank you. All right, so Health, 1159.
Don't be shy, ladies. We still see you.
Gee, why are you calling me a lady? I heard you talking before the meeting, I didn't... So, you have a little bit of increase in the Health Department?
About $9,500. I'm, yeah, $9,500. $5,000 of that is in maintenance agreements.
Right.
We've entered into a new program for food service called, well, it'll be for everything eventually, called Digital Health Department. And that is the first year's maintenance on that. And there's a few other little items, supplies and that sort of thing.
So, and I've asked the auditor this before, I'm going to ask her again. Is this budget sustainable with their...
We believe so.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Motion is second on the floor.
Now, there's no raises on the 144s, right?
Nope, there's not.
Okay.
All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed? The ayes have it.
I want one of those sharp smocks he's wearing.
Antabuse, 2100-2102.
Move.
Second.
Motion is second on the floor, all in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed? Health Maintenance, 1168.
Move. Second.
Motion is second on the floor, all in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? The ayes have it. Health, Tobacco.
Let's approve.
I told you cigarettes were good.
That hasn't run out yet?
That's why Bob's still with us.
I mean, seriously. It's been going on a long time.
Motion is second on Healthy Tobacco.
Healthy Tobacco.
2001, Bob, Healthy Tobacco.
That just went up slightly, but that's due to your hourly FICA.
That, I actually utilize, we've gotten the same amount for those two grant funds, the local health and the trust account for, gosh, the local health has been the same, it's population-based, since we got it in '87, it's been the same amount. The trust account, I actually went down about $2,000 2 years ago. So, when we have carryover, so we're issued the same amount, or, and I utilize carryover sometimes, and I put that in the budget, so I don't have to come back to you for an additional.
Is this budget sustainable with their request? I mean, we're good, right?
They do have raises for their hourly in here.
Yeah, you said that. Is it sustainable?
I haven't really looked at Health Maintenance. This is one of those where, if the fund isn't going to support it, we're not going to pay it out.
Right.
And you guys keep a very good eye on it. It's right now has a balance of about $87,000.
So, with a motion is second on the floor, all in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed? That's it.
Thank you.
Will you call us back for final reading then?
Okay. Sounds good, guys.
That's what we're doing, real cotton.
Excuse me, Health, happy birthday. Happy birthday.
39, huh?
Yeah, holy. Long.
Those holding patterns get long.
Oh, come on, is nobody locked with the flash? Seriously?
Chips.
Auditor.
I got the flash.
Yeah.
Nobody but the flash, Bob.
Only real newspaper in Porter County.
All right.
Hey, Jeff.
Mental note to tell Casardo what Biggs just said.
Well, be...
The honeymoon's over.
Yeah. I think you probably agree with me.
Okay, there are two areas of change in the general fund budget.
Okay.
First, hourly, as I did last year, I'm going to request hourly in the general fund budget. I could be coming here requesting another full-time person, but I don't think it would be approved, because what we're seeing is a need in our mapping division. Our mapping division makes use of the GIS system, so anytime there's a new subdivision, a split, a combine, we have to have a person mapping it out and assigning property tax parcel numbers to each parcel, or else we don't get the tax dollars. There's a backlog. She's doing a great job, but we only have one person in mapping, and she's really asking, she's been asking for some backup help.
I thought all that was moved upstairs.
No, okay, right. GIS, we work with GIS, but now GIS is doing other things with stormwater planning, but a portion of GIS is with the tax mapping, the tax parcel numbering system. Now, GIS used to be in the auditor's office when there were three people in the GIS slash mapping department, so there were three at some point, and he got moved upstairs.
Okay, the mapping that you're doing now, is that something that stormwater will take advantage of?
No, this is pulling up, this is making up parcels and giving them parcels.
Well, they do in the sense that we administer the fee for them, and we worked very closely with them this year on the new stormwater fee, because we had to, we worked really, really hard on getting all of the class codes categorized properly so that all of the fees would be assessed properly. And we came across that problem, which I think all of you know about, where there were agriculture properties, but there was really a home on the agriculture property. That home should be assessed at the stormwater fee of $120, and it wasn't. And so we worked really closely with GIS in reclassifying those codes to get the proper fee on that.
Okay.
So we worked hand in hand. We still work hand in hand with Chuck and the GIS.
Now, the reason I ask is maybe they could, you know, donate a little bit toward that effort.
This is primarily assigning parcel numbers to parcels,
yes.
Correct?
Yes.
And
yes.
That's the auditor.
And one of the things that.
Do you hear anything she said, Jim?
And one of the things that we're kind of beefing up deals with our TIF districts. This year we did our TIF neutralization study in-house. Now this is a really, really big project. Most counties, I believe it's fair to say practically all but maybe one or two, contract this out. We have historically contracted out for good reason. It's a very big, extensive project. And we have a very short period of time to do it, basically in the month of July.
You want $25,000 more for hourly to avoid hiring a full-time person?
Yes.
Okay.
That's it.
What's your pleasure with $825,000?
I'll make the motion.
Second.
All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Thank you, Bob.
Thank you.
GIS mapping.
Ready to.
It's the same.
Joe, your time's been right all night.
It's your pleasure. It's the same.
Yes.
Yes.
Motion.
Is there a second? A little desperate. A little desperate.
I'll second it. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, let's talk about ineligible homesteads.
Oh, Sylvia.
How's that fund running?
Well, right now, you can call up the ledger if you want. You're going to see a fake number. $515,000 right now. So that sounds like a lot, but keep in mind, there's a relatively new state law that requires county auditors to turn back to the general fund monies that are collected in these ineligible homesteads. And for those of you who haven't noticed or read about it, it's something I'm very proud of and I like to brag about it. And I turned back $246,000 to the general fund last year. Well, last year for this year's budget. I'm committed to carrying out this law. And this year, I know we're turning something back. It's not going to be as high as last year. But we're already, everything we bring in is now already going into the general fund.
Atta girl.
Yeah. Well, not immediately. We're going to wait till the end of the year to do that. But
for proper accounting purposes. However, keep in mind, in August, you were so generous in granting an additional appropriation for the new financial software system, financial payroll. So we're going to see that number drop down quite a bit by the end of this year. At least 220 is coming out. Maybe not this year, maybe we won't be invoiced until early next year, but we'll encumber that. But that's going to be for our new FinPay system, and then, of course, whatever I turn back to the general fund.
I'll make the motion.
Second.
However, if you don't mind, I would just like to keep the current budget as is, because when I put together these budgets, we didn't have good costs. We didn't know the timetable.
So the numbers, you want to keep it at 236?
Yes. I put a bunch of budgeted for the new FinPay system, and I don't need it now because of the appropriation.
Excellent. So, I'll amend my motion.
All right. Second concurs, all in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Good job, Vicki. Jail lease rental.
We did that.
We did.
We didn't vote on it.
Yes, we did.
You asked the question of when it expires, and we didn't vote.
2024.
I'll make the motion.
Last payment.
Motion is second, still on the floor. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Good night.
And that is our county's only real debt.
Say that again, that's our county's only real debt.
It is.
Welcome to the most debt-free county in the United States.
You have that lease jail videotech, that lease payment purchase.
Johnny has it bought since 1998.
Someone get a picture of me with Vicks.
Jim.
Thank you, Vicki.
Thank you.